There we go. Stacks out amongst one. There's the front of heaven, Jesus. Hey Mary, my God. Snows down there, over there, man. There's the front of heaven, Jesus. Hey Mary, this way. Oh, God, for God's sake. Hail Mary, full of grace, Lord. Blessed is the Lord, Jesus. Holy Mary, pray for us. Hail Mary, full of grace, Lord. Blessed is the Lord, Lord. Blessed is the Lord, Lord. That long soil and up last us for that I love Jesus, Holy Mary, my God. Hail Mary for Christmas, what he blessed our
defense contracts are based on information from classified documents. An internal inquiry into the leak is in progress. A man found dead of gunshot wounds in Epping Forest.
Maybe on the late side tonight. I'll give you a ring if I can.
Well, at least they're not keeping you past midnight anymore. You seem to have put that particular crisis behind you.
Yes. Yes, I think I have.
Your police liaison bit, wasn't it? When you met that bloke we bumped into in the pub, your Mr. Plod.
Tony Clark. Well, we liaised occasionally at that time, but as I say, that's all in the past.
Could I have your attention, please? I'd like to welcome you to the campaign for the defense of civil rights. Press releases and copies of a tape-recorded interview will be available at the end of this press conference. I'm the campaign's legal officer, Geraldine Dixon. 2 days ago, a man came to this office and asked to meet a lawyer. I spoke to him and took a statement from him, which was also recorded on tape. He told me that he had been pressured into becoming a police informer by the special branch, that he had participated in criminal acts at their instigation, and that his life was now in danger, either from the IRA or from the authorities themselves. That man was Declan Harris. On the evening of the same day, he was murdered.
What it comes down to is aimed you a bullet in the head.
Who from?
People I let down.
Are you talking about the IRA?
Sure. Yeah. Or the special branch.
The accusation that the branch pressured this man and used him as an agent provocateur is bad enough. The implication is they might have shot him. The Home Secretary's been notified of questions in the House. He's biting the Commissioner, who's biting us.
I thought there'd been a comprehensive denial of police involvement with Harris.
Yes. That was the first mistake. Let's make it the final one. The Home Secretary will announce an internal inquiry into Harris's allegations. CIB will do the legwork. And we won't have to do it fast.
Dorothy Bridge, 74 years old, lived alone here, found dead a week ago. Skull fractured by a blunt instrument. Signs that she disturbed a burglar.
No prints.
No, but blood and tissue under her fingernails.
She had a go then.
Oh, yeah. Game old bird, by all accounts. If we had a suspect, forensic could do the business, but we haven't.
Trail gone cold, there you
go. Not too hopeful. Doesn't seem to be anybody in. Let's try around the side.
Yeah.
What it looks like, mate, he was trying to break into the conservatory there. She heard him, challenged him. He whacked her one with whatever implement he was using.
She broke the shelving on her way down.
So that's where the body was found.
Hello? Hi, good afternoon, Mr. Bridge. We did ring at the front. I assumed there was nobody about.
I've been tidying up a bit. It's amazing how rapidly nature gets its own back. I thought you'd finished here.
There we have. Sergeant Naylor's just joined the team. I was bringing him up to speed. There's Simon Bridge, Harry, victim's nephew.
Sorry about your loss, Simon. Next to kin, I believe.
Yes, that's right.
Must have been quite an old lady. I know, tackling burglars at 74, I don't think I'd be doing that. I think I'll be down in 3 nights. In fact, I think that's what I do now. I wonder why she didn't do that.
Well, there's no way of knowing now, is there?
People don't act rationally in a crisis. That's one thing this job teaches you, eh, Harry?
We don't expect to take up any more of your time, Mr. Bridge.
Get back to me as often as you like, if it helps. I'll be here quite a lot. I've taken some leave to get my aunt's affairs sorted out.
Leave?
Civil service.
Oh, yeah. Which department?
Defence.
Ah. I hear they're cutting back. Used to be a job for life like ours, didn't it, Gov?
We'll see ourselves out, Mr. Bridge.
I suppose he's been eliminated, has he? Blood samples, tissues and all that.
Yes, of course he has, Harry. And he's got an alibi. Listen, mate, I don't want us to get off on the wrong foot.
What?
I know it's a knockback being busted to sergeant, but try and live with it, Harry. You're on this firm to carry my bag, do the driving and generally what I tell you. And don't interrupt, Harry. The investigation is in hand. It's not your problem. So enough said.
Here you go.
And we'll have access to all the officers who actually handled Harris, sir.
Well, that may be rather problematic, Tony.
I would have thought it was indispensable.
The Home Secretary wants a report within a matter of days. We may have to base our investigation on the paperwork.
And their records suggest that Harris's connection with Special Branch ended several years ago. The officers in his case may no longer be in service.
That contradicts Harris' assertions on tape, sir.
Yes. It also refutes the ludicrous suggestion that they shot him.
I take it the documents we'll see will include the classified file in which dealings with Special Branch informers are recorded.
Well, it is highly classified, Tony, but I suppose I could ask the Assistant Commissioner and pass on just as much as you need to know.
Here's the PNC printouts on domestic burglars known to be active in the area, plus information from local intelligence officer around here, which gives us suspected burglars who haven't been caught.
Plenty to keep us busy there, Brian. Harry, you want some of this? We'll be putting ourselves about a bit, talking to slags who fit the frame.
I'll tell you what, Gov. I was wondering whether I shouldn't get the crime squad kids organised, do a bit of re-interviewing at the neighbours.
No one heard or saw anything. We've established that.
Well, I was thinking more in terms of background of the victim, you know, family, all that.
Well, if it was an opportunist burglar, Harry, that kind of background isn't the issue, is it?
No, point taken. That's what it looks like, Gov, but, you know, all this nitty-gritty ass-to-ass crap, that's what a crime squad's for, isn't it?
There's no overtime in it, Harry.
I'm aware of that, Gov.
Well, I don't think you'd be punching your weight on that line of inquiry, but I won't stand in your way. Take our girl Friday with you.
But I spoke to you people before.
Yes, Mrs. Ames. To me, actually.
Did you know Miss Bridge very well?
We weren't in and out of each other's kitchens, sharing gossip and recipes. But I got on well with Dorothy, and I shall miss her.
I understand you're a local councillor, Mrs. Ames.
That's right.
Conservative?
Yes.
So you wouldn't have had much common ground with Miss Bridge in terms of politics, I mean, would you?
Dorothy was a great one for what she called progressive causes. Women's Lib, ban the bomb, save the whales, no to nuclear energy, etc., etc. All very sincere, but not much of a threat these days, is it? But not worth falling out over, anyhow.
Did she have many acquaintances in those circles? I mean, you know, did they visit her?
No. This area's not exactly seething with social discontent, and Dorothy was getting a bit past activism. She still gave very generously, though. A faithful unto death. And beyond, if she had her way.
Sorry?
One of her good causes sent her their information pack about making a will. She asked if I'd be a witness. We didn't hear any more about it, so I expect she got someone else to do it.
No family, I believe, just a nephew.
She and Simon were awfully close. It's nice to see that, isn't it? Across the generations.
Yeah, it is, isn't it? What do we know about the terms of the old girl's will?
There wasn't one. She died intestate. The estate's in administration and the administrator is Simon Bridge.
And he stands to cop the lot.
So he wouldn't have been too happy when he found out the old girl was planning to leave the lot to disabled gay whales, would he?
The forensic...
places someone other than Simon Bridge at the scene. But it doesn't say Simon Bridge wasn't there or that he knew nothing about it. What's his alibi?
Spent the night with his girlfriend. She's a doctor, Joanna Gould. She backs up the story.
Mr. Tyler challenged the alibi.
Well...
Come on, Linda.
No. Took the view they were straight.
Well, I'm sure he's right. But maybe you could run the relevant statements past me.
Yeah, sure, Skip.
East case on the special branch. They come up to me and they said, we could get you kicked off and off the mainland. Back where you came from. On an exclusion order. Well, she said I didn't want that. So I did what they asked.
Declan Harris is claiming that's the first contact he had with the branch and that it was initiated by you, Inspector Dilke.
Well, what you have to remember about poor old Declan, sir, is he was a bit of a bullshit artist. Now, if you look at the branch records, you'll see that a call from him was logged to the information room a day before that date, offering information for cash, and that I was assigned to meet him.
Was he pressured?
As the record shows, he came to us. Money was his motive.
Was he threatened with an exclusion order?
No. No grounds for it. He wasn't seriously political back in Ireland.
All right, let's move on.
I said, there's these Republicans in your area. I says, sure, I know who you mean. They're just gobshades. They're not into the armed struggle. They said, well, you could egg them on a bit. Push him over the lane where we can take action?
No. No, Declan came to us and said these guys were planning a robbery to boost Republican funds, and we said, okay, keep us informed, but keep your nose clean.
I realize you've made a statement to us some while ago, Miss Gould, but... Well, there's just a couple of points I want to go over again with you.
Well, I don't think there's any more to be said. Simon spent the evening with me at a concert.
Oh, that'd be the Elgar concert, wouldn't it? This Dream of Geronimo.
That's Gerontius, Skip.
And then we spent the night together.
And you were in his company the whole time?
Yes.
And you're absolutely 100% sure about that?
Well, of course I'm sure.
Do you remember anything out of the ordinary about the night?
Simon's aunt was murdered?
No, I mean anything that struck you at the time.
Well, such as?
Well, his demeanor. Did he appear tense, or was he completely at ease?
He was tense at one point, but then at ease soon after. But that's not uncommon in cases of sexual intercourse.
Well, she's rattled about something.
You don't believe the alibi?
Well, I think I do, as a matter of fact, but the amount of dosh that Dorothy Bridge will cut up for, well, it makes sense for him to rope someone else in, do the job for him, wouldn't it?
What, a contract?
Yeah, in which case, Bridge would take care to set himself up with a credible alibi. Cheers. With a plausible bit of posh.
Rotten sod.
If it's true, Linda, we're only painting pictures at the moment, remember?
But he'll know he's in the frame from Joanna now.
Yeah. And if he's guilty, well, that puts him in a bind, doesn't it? Because if he runs, that's like an admission, and he won't get any benefit. And if he stays, well, he's not half going to get sweaty, is he?
How do you know?
Because we'll make sure he does.
When it came to court, I was the only one who walked, right? So the boys have got my cards marked good and proper. They've got me down as a tout.
Didn't you get protection from the special branch?
Well, I did that time, I suppose. Change of name, change of address. Then they were on to me for more work.
The same offices.
Bastard who got me into all this.
When was this?
6 months ago.
Now, this bit's complete bollocks.
Can you comment at the end, please?
And what did they ask you to do this time?
Jobs. Of work, you know what I mean?
Criminal acts.
Yes. What it comes down to is aimed you a bullet in the head.
Who from?
People I let down.
Are you talking about the IRA?
Sure. Yeah. Other special branch.
Although that last stuff's off the wall. We've had no dealings with Harris for 5 years.
Well, how do you explain what Harris said?
Well, like I said, he was a piss artist. The drink does that to you, doesn't it? Also, he was a pathological liar into the bargain. Anything to get attention.
Harris may have said and done a lot of things to boost his own ego, but he couldn't have shot himself twice in the back of the head, could he, Mr. Dilke?
Mrs. Berridge, I'm glad I bumped into you. Your office hasn't been returning my calls.
Someone's dead, Mr. Deakin. Something to discuss.
I think that means I'm entitled to some assurances.
No, Mr. Deakin. From the point of people like you, you're not entitled to anything.
Bloody police around again.
So, basically, Gov, we have been able to eliminate certain individuals from our inquiries. Others we're still interested in. And the criminal fraternity is well aware that we will be giving them grief. Spins and pulls at all hours until we get some assistance.
Right, Brian, keep up the good work, and that goes for all of you. I don't want anybody slacking off because we're in the quiet routine phase of this inquiry. Any questions, comments, suggestions?
Yeah, Gov.
Harry?
I think we should bring Simon Bridge and Joanna Gould in for interview.
They've been interviewed.
Not as suspects.
Make your point, Harry.
Right. I can show motive for Bridge. Gould is his alibi, but I think she's been manipulated. We can break her. Bridge is already feeling the pressure, and I don't think he's got a front for a full-scale interview.
Well, I think Harry and I should get our heads together on this one. Maybe a very promising line of inquiry. Meanwhile, you've all been tasked, so let's go to work. Linda, you've been angel and rustle up some tea?
Yes, go.
Harry? You might be under the impression that upstaging my inquiry is a shortcut to getting your pips back. That could be a big mistake, Harry, and you can't afford another one.
No, Gov. But you see, all those years I spent at CIB made me realise what an inquiry like this looks like when somebody rakes it over years later. And if you haven't covered all the angles, the journalists drop you down a carsy, and the appeal courts will pull the chain.
All right, Harry. You want some rope? You can have it.
My impression of Harris was that he looked and sounded at the end of his tether. He could well have been up all night and was probably still under the influence of drink. However, that doesn't mean his statement can be dismissed.
We're investigating Harris's allegations, not dismissing them.
I hope so. Now, if you'll excuse me, I have to be in Manchester this afternoon. Miscarriage of justice, would you believe?
Just a couple more points, Miss Dixon. Harris came here and made his statement. Now, what did he want from that?
He had a desperate hope that it would deter the people who were after him. Would there be no point in shutting him up once the facts were on record?
That would only apply to the special branch, not to the IRE.
Perhaps he saw them as a more serious threat. Well, he's dead. I can't read his mind.
What Harris says is very vague. I'm surprised you didn't press him for particulars.
He seemed reluctant to go into details. Given the state he was in, it didn't seem the right time to put the pressure on. I thought, wrongly, that there'd be another opportunity. I mean, I cocked it up, if that's what you want to hear. And I bitterly regret it. Christ, we all get things wrong. Some of us admit it. Dixon. Yes, thank you. I'll be right down. My taxi.
I'm sure you did your best for him, Miss Dixon. He was well advised to come here. Did he say why he chose this particular organization?
Trevor Bull put him onto us. They'd done time together.
Trevor Bull, that name's familiar.
Should be. Firearms officers put 5 rounds into him at the scene of a robbery and then charged him with attempted murder.
Trevor!
No unfinished business between us, Mr. Deakin. We're all square.
Just wanted to make sure. After what happened to Declan, people might come pestering you.
Be wasting their time, wouldn't they? I don't know anything. You don't worry about me.
There's only one person I really don't have to worry about, Trevor. That's poor old Declan.
You've missed him, I'm afraid. He left this morning on a trip.
Check out down here.
Not a day trip, then.
Yeah, you pushed your luck with the governor, Harry, my boy. But it looks like you're coming up smelling of roses, eh?
This is D.I. Cope. Please put out the following description.
Check the bird's boat.
Mr. Sullivan thought I should communicate some developments to you, Tony.
Oh, yeah.
The Assistant Commissioner's had an opportunity to study the branch's classified file on Harris.
Uh-huh.
Contact with Harris ceased 5 years ago. It bears out Dilke's account.
Well, it would, wouldn't it? If everyone was doing their job properly.
Yes, of course. However, there is a cross-reference in the file to RUC criminal record.
Whoa. Harris has got form in Northern Ireland. I was told he was clean.
Well, there may have been some confusion. Harris was never on offer for any political crap, housebreaking and theft, what he did time for.
And Dilke knew this?
Well, according to the classified file, it only came to light after Harris made contact with Special Branch. It still leaves Harris initiating the relationship, not being blackmailed into it. The Assistant Commissioner felt you ought to have this information contextualised.
In case I found out on my own and got funny ideas.
What I like about this place is they don't overcook the vegetables.
Well, it looks like the Assistant Commissioner has drafted the report to the Home Secretary already, doesn't it, sir?
Always pays to be ahead of the game, Anthony.
This is the police. Heath 2. I repeat, Heath 2. Ease your speed and stop.
Give you long, Gov. My suspects are on the way.
Very chirpy you look on it, too. Enjoying life at the sharp end, eh?
I'll manage, let's put it that way.
Now, what do you reckon about RUC Special Branch being involved with Harris? I mean, you've been over there.
Yeah, I was seconded, along with a lot of other branch officers.
Well, what if Harris was already an informer before he left Belfast?
Well, yeah, villains like Harris were pressurized all the time to become agents.
So the bastard he talks about who got him into it in the first place could be his RUC handler.
And that's who made contact again recently.
That's not the answer that's wanted, though, is it?
No. I guess all that stuff's in more highly classified files.
Well, it might be and it might not. I mean, a lot of branch officers set up their own private networks. And they'd say it was more secure. That was Deakin's line, anyway.
Deakin was into all that, was he?
Well, yeah, but not just him. It's another country over there, Gov. They do things different, you know? Well, I'll ask you the question again, Joanna. Why were you running away?
That's your term for it. We weren't running away, we just went for a trip. Needed the air. Things have been heavy.
You see, I think you were frightened. I think you're frightened now.
Well, we're subject to police harassment.
No. You're subject to police interest. Now, why would that frighten you?
We're not the sort of people who interest the police.
Let's go back to the night of the murder, Joanna. Now, you told us that Simon Bridge was with you the whole night. Do you still say that?
Yes.
When Simon spends the night with you, are these stopovers just spur-of-the-moment things? Well, you know, like my fella. He comes over, he gets pissed, says he can't drive home, and before I know it, he's talked his way to some nookie.
We happen to think personal autonomy is rather important. We spend the night together by arrangement.
Simon booked up for the concert by credit card 2 weeks before the night in question. Did he suggest stopping over?
I don't remember. Quite possibly I did.
But it was all set up well in advance, basically at Simon's instigation.
You're getting this so completely wrong.
Well, put it right for us then, Joanna.
Well, Simon's not a murderer, for God's sake. He loved the old lady. She was the only family he had.
But that's not the question, Joanna. Simon's an intelligent and resourceful man. He'll be answering for himself. You've got your own interests to consider, haven't you?
Well, Harris has no immediate family. He doesn't seem to have made any friends.
Apart from the ones he grassed up.
Exactly. It would be nice to hear about him from someone who wasn't a copper. You do a PNC check on this Trevor Bull who sent him to the Defence of Civil Rights mob.
Yeah, sure.
What's up? You got grief?
No. No, I've got through to the final interview.
Oh. Well, I should hope so. You'll walk it. Inspector Connell. No problem. It's about time you made the move, Mo. You've been in CIV long enough. Even longer than I have. I've had a gutful.
Well, you never know with things like this. At the end of the day, there might not be a vacant post. I'll get that PNC check done for you.
According to our estimates, you stand to gain in excess of £300,000 from your aunt's death. As the administrator of her affairs, you'd be aware of that.
Yes. That doesn't mean I murdered her.
Were you aware of your aunt's plans in respect to her property?
As you must have been told, we were very close to each other. She talked about the idea of making a will with bequests to causes she supported. I fully understood and made no attempt to dissuade her. It was her business.
Despite the loss to you in the long run.
Money isn't the be-all and end-all of existence. It wasn't for my aunt, and it isn't for me. There are more important things.
What would they be, Simon?
Living one's life according to certain standards. Acting generously and honorably. Opposing others when they are selfish or dishonorable.
You set yourself very high standards, Simon. Tell me, a man who likes to live by those standards, he'd be prepared to take responsibility for his own actions, wouldn't he? I mean, he wouldn't want another person especially like a loved one lying for him, putting herself in a compromising position for him, would he?
What I'm saying is that I didn't kill my aunt and that financial gain would not have motivated me to do so.
You're lying to us, Simon.
I'd like to talk to a solicitor now, please.
If that's what you want, I am suspending this interview in order for Mr. Bridge to consult his solicitor. The time is
1752. I've worked in Nick's that had less security than that.
Rough old area.
Well, only because people like Bull live in it. GBH, armed robbery, attempted murder.
No, he got off on attempted murder.
Well, thanks to the civil rights people and the fact that it was tried at Snaresbrook. Extreme caution should be exercised. That sounds sensible.
What they mean?
Surround the place with firearms. Get the TSG to do the door and send in dogs. I don't want to pull him, I just want to talk to him.
It's not so much what you want, it's what he wants. All those 9 milli rounds might have left him that wee bit anti-police.
Probably doesn't realise how much good we do in the community. Mr. Bull?
Who wants to know?
My name's Clark. There's nothing to worry about, but I am a police officer.
You're wrong.
No, it's nothing like that, Mr. Bull. You're not in any trouble.
Shut it.
It's your late friend, Declan Harris, we're interested in.
It's interesting he killed me. You know what it did for him.
I'm in complaints investigation, Mr. Bull. If that's true, I want to know about it.
Piss off.
I wonder how a paranoid like that behaves when he's actually been persecuted.
There's one way to find out.
Do you have a solicitor you'd like us to call, or shall we find one for you?
I have my own. Pauline McNichol of McNichol and Flower.
Right, Simon. You'll be returned to your cell, and we'll let you know when your solicitor can get here.
You looked a bit hooky when you mentioned the brief, Harry. If you think she's dodgy, we could ask the governor to exclude her.
No, Brian, no. It's another case name rings a bell, that's all. Nothing to worry about.
Well, he's all ready to put his hands up.
What?
Isn't he, Harry?
What? Bridge? Oh, yeah. He wants to get something off his chest, that's for certain.
Well, let's hope the brief doesn't put the mockers on it.
Mo?
Well?
McNichol and Flower, solicitors, you remember?
Sure. Their alarm was taken offline when you were moonlighting at the security firm.
Yeah, and I got bunk 500 quids to forget it, right?
Look, Harry, I thought we were all agreed. The solicitors didn't report a burglary. There was nothing to forget.
Well, whatever. McNichol and Flower are back in the picture. They're Simon Bridges' solicitors that you at the Nick to advise him.
Well, so what? Coincidence. There's only so many briefs in London. I mean, what could the connection be?
Oh, I don't know. I just don't like the feeling of the waterworks, you know.
That'll be the accumulated alcohol. Just you ignore it. When Simon Bridge admits to killing his Auntie Dorothy, you'll have your body and your brownie points, and you can stop worrying about things that never happened.
Yeah.
Look, I'll run it past the governor when he surfaces, but he's dealing with a paranoid of his own right now.
Advised my client of his rights and reminded him of his right to remain silent. However, he feels he'd like to set the record straight at this point by making a statement.
In the course of my work as a senior civil servant at the Ministry of Defence, I became aware of malpractices in the awarding of procurement contracts, which I believe to be against the public interest. To expose this matter, I removed items of classified information and I have been leaking their contents to the press. I came under suspicion with other officials who had access to the material. We were questioned in a routine manner, and then I believe my home was illegally entered and searched in my absence.
Did you inform the police about this?
There were no obvious signs of a burglary. Just papers not precisely arranged as I'd left them. And besides, I'd be admitting that I was in breach of the Official Secrets Act.
Were the classified documents in your possession?
No. At that time, they were lodged with my solicitors in a sealed package. They weren't aware of the contents. I thought they might be the next target, so I arranged for the material to be put into my aunt's safekeeping.
Ms. McNichol, were your premises burgled?
Not that we're aware of. But then if it was a clandestine search for material that wasn't there, we wouldn't know, would we?
I knew that there was risk involved, and I told my aunt exactly what I'd done and why. We shared the same ethical standpoint. She agreed with my decision and knowingly took charge of the material. I believe that she was killed for it.
And the material is now missing?
Yes.
Why didn't you tell us any of this before?
Because I was bloody frightened. And I still am. I tried to ring my aunt on the night of the murder. The phone was out of order. It was working all right the following day. And that's not your common or garden opportunist burglar, is it? That's professional. Or should I say official?
Tell the public your car isn't a strong box. Best you can do is slow the hyenas down.
You turn right, Liberty, you know that.
Yeah.
You're really hanging yourself out for it.
That's threatening behaviour, Trevor. Then there's being in charge of a vehicle when you're over the limit.
Bollocks, you need uniforms.
Oh, they're not far away. All ready to roll. Wanna talk to them? And that dog of yours looks a bit illegal to me.
His pedigree, I've got papers.
Yeah, but if you turned nasty while they were finding out, they might have to shoot him just to be on the safe side. Bastard. Oh, go on, take a pop at me. Assaulting a police officer would do nicely.
And, what I'd put money on is that a man as nervous as you would be tooled up to protect himself.
I think I'm silly.
Well, you want to put it to the test? Search a car? You sure we won't find something? I mean, if there wasn't a Stanley knife, a long screwdriver would do. You see, it's intention that matters with offensive weapons, and, who'll believe you?
I can't believe you're sitting here offering to fit me up.
All I want you to do, Trevor, is to talk to me sensibly about what I want to know. Who first recruited Declan Harris as an informer, and who put him back to work a few months ago?
How should I know?
Well, you sent him to the campaign for the defense of civil rights, so he must have talked to you about his problems.
Yeah, well, if he did talk to me, you couldn't use it anyway. I mean, what a dead man might have said to me ain't worth bollocks as far as evidence is concerned.
Oh, you didn't waste your time in Nick, did you? GCSE in law, was it? Look, I'm not looking to use you as a witness. I'd rather stand your dog up in court. What I want from you is the truth.
You take care of this, Goose, if you've been out of order.
That's what I'm for.
A copper called Deakin put a black on Harris in Belfast years ago. It's what Harris told me. Harris grassed a load of people up out there. It was on him. He had to get out to England. Anyway, before long, he was skint, what with a drink and everything. So he found Special Branch, offered him information. Only trade he ever had apart from burglary.
What about recently?
Deakin contacted him again, offered him work, breaking and entering. All sanctioned. You know what I'm talking about, no comebacks.
Do you ever meet this Deakin?
Nah. I wouldn't know if I met him.
And who did Harris say Deakin was working for?
Special Branch still. Obvious.
So that puts me right back in the bind again. I can tie Deakin's firm into these burglaries because I know they knocked the alarm off at the solicitors. But that puts me back on offer for covering up in the first place.
If Harry's case is reopened, they're bound to do his legs because he's well into overdraft as far as favours are concerned.
Harry can stay stum.
I hope you're joking.
We're talking about murder here. I mean, Christ, there are limits, you know.
You don't know the half of it. We can square the circle here. I've just been told that Harris was doing jobs for Deakin. Now, I reckon that includes the burglary at Dorothy Bridge's place and her nephews and the solicitors.
You're saying Harris murdered Mrs. Bridge?
Well, that's my guess. And if Forensic backs it up by placing Harris at the scene, then I'm going to dump so much on Deakin, he'll think he's standing under Nelly the Elephant.
You do like to live up to your reputation, don't you?
These are remarkable intuitions, Tony. Characteristically bold.
With all due respect, sir, this didn't come to me in a vision while I was inhaling prohibited substances. It is based on information received plus legitimate inference. It is capable of proof by forensic examination and further inquiry.
Very possibly, but not by us. The Bridge Murder Squad is now pursuing the forensics on Harris, and the inquiry into Harris's murder may well find your information suggestive. But our business has been to examine the relationship between Harris and the Met Special Branch, and we can't show anything wrong with that, can we?
Well,
so that's what we'll report to the Assistant Commissioner for the benefit of the Home Secretary.
What about Deakin?
Deakin is not a serving officer.
Harris thought Deakin was working for Special Branch.
What Harris thought is as far beyond recovery as the back of his head. And if Deakin did pose as a Special Branch officer, it's still not the affair of this department.
There mustn't be any suspicion that we're underwriting a personal vendetta of yours, Tony. I'm sure you can see that.
If Deakin was acting as an agent for Special Branch, doing their work, deniable burglary in this case, with their knowledge, then that would be our business, wouldn't it? So, unless I'm ordered not to, in writing, that's what I'm going to investigate.
Blood and tissue samples removed from Dorothy Bridge's fingernails match the corpse of Declan Harris. We got a result.
Woo!
Right, Brian. Round up the boys and girls. Organise a piss-up.
Sugar.
Well, 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 Sergeant Naylor. It wasn't Simon Bridge.
No, and it wasn't an opportunist burglar either.
Yes, there's a warrant which appears to be in order, but I would like you here as an objective witness to any theft, vandalism, or planting of evidence which may be attempted. No, I haven't been arrested. I haven't been placed under caution. In fact, so far, I haven't even been assaulted. Which could suggest that Superintendent Clark may be showing belated signs of maturity.
No, I'm afraid of what I might catch.
As soon as you can, then, Clive.
Take a break, ma.
Right, Gov.
See you down there.
Maureen. Good luck with your interview. And be advised, at this delicate point in your career, don't let yourself get involved in anything swift.
Can we talk?
I'm not under caution.
If you were under caution, you wouldn't say anything.
I won't say anything anyway.
Then I'll arrest you.
Then I'll be under caution.
Sure, but you'd be in the discomfort of a police station for maybe 24 hours. Or if I took you to a nick where the superintendent hates your guts, and they do exist, John, believe me, we could stretch it to 36.
I could sue the bollocks off the Met for wrongful arrest.
Well, you could try. But that'd be way in the future. The detention would be right now.
Sit down. Drink?
Just the one.
Well then, we're talking.
Did you pressurize Declan Harris to become an agent when you were seconded to RUC Special Branch?
Whether I did or I didn't is an official secret.
There's machinery for getting at those these days, you know.
Not the good ones.
Harris was working for you when he burgled Simon Bridges' flat, McNichol and Flowers' office and Dorothy Bridges' home, wasn't he?
Prove it.
And you were acting as an agent for Special Branch to get those jobs done, weren't you?
I'll tell you as much as a sensible man would want to know. You've shown that Harris killed Dorothy Bridge. That was unauthorized, the work of a burglar disturbed in the act.
I note what you're not denying.
I note that I'm not under caution.
Who shot Harris?
It was the provisional IRA execution of an informer following court-martial, as laid down in the Army Council's general orders. They can be very fussy about the formalities.
Harris hadn't operated against them for years. If it was the provisional IRA, how did he know it was imminent?
Celtic people are gifted that way. Yes? Send him in. My brief. Now the footsie has to stop.
I blew it last time. There won't be an action replay. When I come back to pull you, I'll have a case as watertight as the arsehole on a duck.
Not from the bump you've carted out of here today.
Maybe not. But I will take you the distance, by whatever means necessary.
Big boys' games. Big boys' rules.
Never mind that. The thing is, there's a lot more that needs to be said.
Could we meet?
Yeah, of course we can.
Thanks, Tony. It does matter to me.